Notion is a godsend. I use it for many aspects of my life, but especially for my creator space. I have three main sections here. First, I use Notion as the database for my website, so everything in this section will touch the internet in some way. It's useful to be able to update stuff on the go. For example, if I need to cancel a video or stream for the week, I make it easy to announce that, or when someone DMs me their Team C's donation, I can quickly add the receipt, and everything updates in real time on my website without having to rebuild all the time. I also have it hooked up to Zapier to add all my tweets to the database because that shows up on my website as well. These are all technical things, but I thought I'd include them to give you an idea of how powerful Notion can be. Here I have my creator space overview. I've included a template version in the description. You can follow along and even duplicate it into your own Notion workspace. We have a simple Kanban board that I call the docket. This is for arbitrary stuff I have to do without a deadline. Underneath that, I have a daily tasks guide. I don't always follow it, but it's good for reference to keep me on top of things. There are three major sections that help my workflow: brainstorming, content, and post-posting. I've also included a reference view to the upload schedule, which I will talk about in a minute. This makes it easy to see at a glance what my month will look like. First, let's visit the brainstorming area. Underneath, I have little storytelling helpers. They're all included in the Notion template, so they're available for you to explore later. I have a little inspiration page where I dump cool art, although to be honest, I usually just use Pinterest instead. We also have a fun little favorites Q&A. Feel free to fill that out as well. Now to the brain dumping area. Something I've recently started working on is a series table. For example, this video is part of my 1 year on YouTube series. Having this view makes it easy to find videos that should be worked on simultaneously. If an idea doesn't have an upload date planned yet, they get dumped into an ideas category. A category template makes it easy to create new Kanban boards. There are three main sections: great ideas, need refinement, and duds. As I said last week, you should have more duds and needs refinement ideas than great ideas. That's a good sign. This is the area where I tend to social media and channels other than my main YouTube videos. We have international monthly events, and I drag the current month up to the top and keep it open. This makes it easy to keep in mind what's going on this month. Here's a simple list of ideas of kinds of posts. I recently incorporated this app called Notion Instagram, but I haven't tried it yet. It's supposed to be useful for scheduling Instagram posts. This is a content calendar. Right now I only use it to keep track of international and national events. It gives me a good idea of worldly topics that I can look into or post about. In the templates, you can see that I also use it to keep track of other content, for example, Twitch stream outlines, Discord date nights, and my quarterly Spotify playlists. But the main focus for me right now is YouTube, so I have an entire section dedicated to it, post-posting. First, I have some different description templates. These get linked into page templates, so I only have to edit them in one place. There is a newer area that I call unsolicited advice. This is the unrelated piece of advice that I include at the end of each video. I can brainstorm some ideas here and I check them off if I've used them. Side note, the goal for this was to decrease the sharp drop at the end of my videos where I used to put an end screen. It has worked very well so far. Actually, in this recent video, I didn't include a piece of advice and the drop-off came back, so I will continue this until it stops working. Next, I have a little bookmark page for quick access, and I favorite this so it pins up at the top. Here, I have this area that has been untouched since I started my channel last year. My main goal by November 11th was to reach 1,000 subscribers to unlock the community tab. I did reach that. I also included some quick links and charity resources. I refer to these whenever I'm in the post-posting stage that I talked about last week. At the end of each month, I drop a couple of my brainstorming ideas into the upload schedule. Here, I fill out a bunch of properties to understand the point of the video, and then I have this video template that I've included in your Notion template below. It preps out everything I'll need to start planning. I already talked about scripting in my last video, so go check that out if you're curious about the process. What's more important, though, is to favorite the next 3 or 4 videos that I need to be working on. This way, I can conveniently refer to each video idea, the script, or video description. This is the most useful part of my entire Notion organization, so thanks for sticking around this far into the video. This template alone is pretty much all you need to start planning your YouTube videos. So that's everything in the creator space. I am currently working on an improvement section, but that probably won't be ready until 2022. As always, thank you for watching, and if you ever see one of these guys, do not pick him up.